Professional house cleaners of Reddit. What do most people need to clean in their home, but don't? When I did housekeeping during college, I noticed that many people neglect to take down their shower curtains periodically for washing. That's the accumulation of body oils, fluids, etc. that has splashed off your body. You can disinfect and make a bathroom sparkle. However, the stench off the ripe curtain, ick. A little tip for anyone with shower curtains. Open it up after use. If you leave it all crinkled up, it'll get mucky much more quickly. Coming from someone who is taller than average, I'd like to mention that many people only clean to their R-level. SLPT. Be 5 feet 0 like me, so you have to clean less. The dish drying rack. I've never seen anyone with one that wasn't freaking horrific looking. I'll admit, I don't clean mine as often as I can, but there's a difference between calcium etc. deposits and straight up mold algae. I've never gotten the latter. People who are busy but wonder how it looks different when I do it. The finishing touches they miss are polishing or wiping down their kitchen bin, kettles and other shiny things on their counters. One job I struggle with is removing hair from a plug hole, and as I rule, I don't do it because I'll spend the day heaving. People forget to clean their taps, door handles and light switches, yet they are probably the most used item. Yes, these are the things that make a room look great. In fact, you could forego a lot of the actual cleaning and just do these things and people would think the room is clean. The blade of their can opener. I cleaned houses in college. Clean your microwaves, people. Baseboards and windows are less disgusting, but more often neglected. If you have toddlers, short children, the entire inside perimeter of your house at the 2.5 feet mark has a layer of snot encrusted dirt that's built up over the years that you are most likely blind to by now. Ugh, true and nasty. We repainted with scrubbable paint, and within a few months there was already a noticeable tide mark, which we can now scrub. Children are actually completely gross, even the clean ones. Not a pro, but worked housekeeping at a hotel for a bit. Wash your walls. You don't have to go all out, just if you see scuffs, wipe them off. Even if you're not smoking inside or anything, so much grime builds up on walls. Their fans. MFSB having the dustiest ceiling fans in the world. How do y'all sleep with those things spinning? It's like snow. I only think about it when I accidentally reverse the rotation of the fan, and it starts flinging fan worms everywhere. Clean your light switches and doorknobs, they are always gross and people rarely clean them. Here's one people never do but really should. Vacuum your mattress. No, I'm not kidding. When you change your sheets, you should vacuum that bee so you can suck out whatever dead skin and crap have made their way down there. Also, we all know to wash the fitted sheet. But below that, mattresses sometimes have another removable cover. Please wash that too. I don't know why it never occurred to me to do this. In my head, it's fine because the fitted sheet is the barrier between your body and the mattress. But obviously stuff gets through. I need to stop reading this thread. I'm learning so much, but at the cost of my peace of mind. Clean the things you use to clean other things. Replace your kitchen sponge at least twice a month. Wash your towels weekly. Leave the door to your washing machine open after each cycle so it doesn't mildew. You get the idea. If these things aren't clean, it can manifest in big ways. Ever met one of those people who has a faint musty sour smell even after showering? Chances are they've been using the same nasty bath towel for weeks, months and don't notice the smell from it anymore. Not a pro, but the one that always gets neglected is the extractor fan hood over your cooker. There are filters on there that need replacing, or just cleaning depending on the type, and if you don't, after about 6-12 months they turn into a fire hazard because they get saturated with grease. If you put your hand onto the flat underside of your extractor hood and it feels greasy and gross, that's because it is. Clean that crap once in a while, folks. You can put them in the dishwasher, they come out sparkling. Honestly, even in the wealthiest of homes, the bathrooms were an absolute nightmare. Grime so thick on the walls you could make an entire bar of soap out of it. Hard water stains were even harder. We had this fancy pumice stone that we'd use to scrub majority of it away. A lot of us would use toilet bowl cleaner on the entire bathroom. It had some really strong compounds that would just cut right through that stuff. I found out recently that my childhood home has traces of silica sand in the water, which explains why I could never get the grime off of the sliding glass door to the shower. Apparently the water is so hard that it would etch glass. I have a house cleaner and she says the most neglected spots are doors and window frames. Both get pretty gross, especially white doors around the handle, but people don't notice until it's pointed out. Oh my god, the window frames. I worked as a housekeeper in Cairns, QLD for a few months. Remove the sliding windows entirely if possible and use a kitchen knife and a cloth to get all the dirt and debris out of there. You will find pebbles, dust, sand, dead insects, even geckos if they live in your area. The fan heaters. I unplug mine and use a skinny crochet hook to yank the hair and dust out of ours. I have seen one catch fire. Clean them. It's important. Same with the funk that builds up on hair dryers. Garbage disposal flaps, black mold under there, dishwasher filters, grossest things ever. Till dishwashers have filters. Time to find them in all the houses where I use a dishwasher, and probably be horrified. I used to clean luxury apartments in the Upper East Side in college, and no matter how clean the apartments looks, there were a few places people will often forget to clean. 1. Microwaves. 2. Behind the stove. Yes, food falls down there. I once cleaned someone's stove and there was popcorn kernels from 2010. This guy had a strict diet, so he was able to remember the last time he ate popcorn. 3. Window blinds. The guy had white blinds, and with time dirt it looked yellow dark white. 4. Behind the fridge and clean inside the fridge. I used to clean apartments from doctors and lawyers and their places would be dirty. They would always be amazed how I was able to find hidden garbage. They would always appreciate my work, and always gave me a tip or bonus. I am so happy the stove in my house is inlaid in the counter, so no food can fall behind. I've seen some houses with some nasty stoves, spots of spaghetti, dried up chili beans. Please everyone, clean your freaking stove after you cook. You can also clean under a lot of electric stovetops. Just take the burners out and lift the whole metal top up. A more realistic one that my mum told me, clean between the seat and the tank on the toilet. According to her, it's a deal breaker for some chicks. I've visited some friends in UK a year ago and I still remember the ridiculous amount of pubes around the toilet seat, specifically between the seat and the tank, and on the floor between the toilet and the bathtub, and on the bathroom mat. Pubes. Pubes everywhere. I've been cleaning for a few years now, mostly office buildings but occasionally post-move-out post-renovation cleans. The biggest things I've seen people neglect to clean for literally years are underneath toilet seats, inside bathroom drawers, inside medicine cabinets and bathtubs. So many bathtubs caked with pink sludge that's a mixture of soap scum and skin, really made me start paying attention to the little things when cleaning my own spaces. Not a cleaner, but was a mover in Japan. People need to clean the backs, top, sides, and underneath of their fridge. It gets real nasty after a while. Like super mega gross. Professional cleaner of 12 years here. Please clean your fridge. The amount of spilt food and crumbs that can build up in these is pretty disgusting. Change your bed sheets more than once every few months. I change mine at least once every 2 weeks. Inside of the kitchen bin. Bleach it. Scrub it, it's vile but a necessary evil. Give your cutlery drawer a clean today, cause I guarantee none of you will have for years. Bathrooms need more than a small wipe once every few months. You crap in here and the bacteria gets everywhere. I'm talking full bleach every month and a proper wipe with flash with bleach and or other cleaning sprays. Limescale builds up easily and fast and it's a freaking pain to clean off when it gets bad, so keep on top of it. Wash your towels and bed linen at high temperatures to kill bacteria. They won't shrink like clothes will. Bleach your sink regularly too as it keeps it smelling fresh. Outside your entryways. If you keep your stoop swept and the garage floor relatively clean, you will track in a lot less crud. Also, if you have pets, vacuum your furniture once in a while. I spent over an hour once removing dog and cat hair from a living room set. Also, behind your toilet. It gets dusty there. Plus urine of anyone with the dong lives there. Also, spiders like that spot for some reason. Swap out your kitchen sponge, please. Saw my sister use it to clean up dog crap pee then throw it back into the sink. Freaking hate how disgusting they are. This is for all the video gamers out there. Please clean your gaming equipment. Get some disinfecting wipes and clean down your controllers. Clean your keyboard about twice a year. If you eat at your computer, clean it once a month. Clean your mouse about twice a year. Disinfect your mouse and keyboard once a month. It will help you get sick less. Dust your electronics once a month. It will help keep them from overheating and last longer. Clean your headset once a month. Your hair oil is slowly sticking to it and that allows it to grab dust. It gets really gross. At least once a year, remove your gaming electronics from their tables and shelves to dust and clean down the area. I have found even the most crazy of clean freaks for some reason neglect their gaming equipment. Toilet brush and toilet brush holder. These just become a stew of poop particles if ignored. Does vacuum filter count? I'm a carpet laying apprentice and sometimes we use the customer's vacuum to tidy up. Usually they're a useless sack of crap and you have to empty it and clean the filter. Then they're good as new. Something I didn't notice until I sat on the floor the other day. Places your pets, cats in particular, rub against. My door jams and walls were very dirty at cat level. I didn't see this mentioned. Lighting fixtures and hood vent. Baking soda is a very good friend of mine. Slightly off topic, but related. If you hire a house cleaner, don't waste their time. Clean your house before they arrive. Wash dishes, pick up dirty clothes, make beds, etc. So they can concentrate on getting to the difficult and hidden things that get missed. We have a cleaner come in for a couple of hours 3 days a week. And I don't know how many times I've had to tell my girlfriend to put the dishes in the dishwasher so the cleaner can spend time on more important cleaning. The toothbrush holder. Your spit and saliva drips down the bottom of brushes into the cup. Nasty. Not a professional and a little off topic, but have you ever cleaned your steering wheel? My god, the stuff that shows up on a Lysol wipe. Your ceilings. Fly crap in summer ice and a laughing matter. I have honestly never in my near 24 years thought of flies crapping, until this moment. Always clean from ceiling to floor. Dust dirt falls down as you go, so you'll just make more work for yourself if you don't clean from top to bottom. You have been visited by the Holy Fruit Boy. If you comment Tiny Turtle, he will bless you with unlimited holy fruits. If you are new to the channel, you can subscribe. I publish new videos every day. Until then, check out another video. Or don't. Either way, have a great day, you magnificent people.